Hello, welcome to the lecture series presented by St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management. My name is Ravinder. I am an assistant professor with ETCE department, and we are discussing the broad topic of programming for problem solving using C. Okay. And for past few lectures, we are discussing the topic of errors. We have reached a point where we will be capable of doing some manipulations and some can actually play with 2D errors. So let's see what are those. We have discussed briefly in last lecture what are 2D errors. Now we'll discuss them in detail, and we will also see an example how to implement these 2D arrays in C language. Actually, we'll go to the editor to see how we are going to implement that. After, I'll give you a short description. So let's get through it. So yesterday we have discussed how we are going to declare the two-dimensional arrays in C. So as I have told you before, first we have to write the data type. So what kind of data your array is going to hold. Next, with a space, you're going to write the name of the array. That is, by what name you're going to call your array. After that, two square brackets. Now these two square brackets will hold the dimensions of the two-dimensional array, that is the number of rows and number of columns. So the index inside first square bracket will always depict the number of row or in which row you are currently in, and the next square bracket will always depict in which column you are in right now. Let's see what I'm trying to say. So we'll do something like, let's say int, and I want my array to be named as, let's say, x1, and first square bracket will hold the number of rows, and second will hold the number of columns, and that is it. And in actuality, it will look something like, say, x1 and let's say 4 and 4, and this is it. Okay, this is how it will look like. So by this line, by writing this particular line, I have initialized an array with 4 columns and 4 rows. So it will look something like, let's see. Sorry. And so we have 4 number of rows and 4 number of columns. So this particular array is defined like this using your C syntax. Okay, so let's get back to the notes. Okay. Now that we have seen how we are going to declare an array, we can see how we are going to initialize it. Now there are two ways to initialize a two-dimensional array. The first is by hard coding the values, by hard coding the actual data points in the code itself, by using something like this. Okay, as we have seen in the case of one-dimensional arrays, we can insert the values of the arrays by hard coding it inside your code, but that is not an let's say optimized way to to make an application, because it will not provide you the flexibility that you want while dealing with any kind of problem. So if you want your array to have some other values than you have previously inserted, then you have to go back to your code and then hard code it again. Well, there is one more way to do that, that is by inserting the values dynamically, that is by asking the user to input those values from the keyboard itself. We have seen an example while we are studying one-dimensional arrays. We will see it again right now. Okay, so here you can see that we have initialized this array with values by hard coding it. That is, I have this particular array called ARR has 4 number of rows and 3 number of columns. So we have provided 4 small arrays actually. Each array will depict a single row, and each smaller array has 3 element inside, which depicts an element for each column. Okay, so first row, second row, third row, and fourth. That is it. The one way to do that, one way to initialize your 2D array is this. Now we'll go back to our IDE and see how we are going to insert the values of our two-dimensional arrays dynamically. That is by asking the user to input those values. So let's go back to the IDE. Okay, let's start writing a new code, a new file. So let's start with the header files. So we'll include two directories that are predefined, and we'll start our main function. Obviously, we are not going to write any arguments, and the curly brackets will include the main body. So first, I will define a two-dimensional array. So I want my array to be of type int, that is integer. And then the name, say name is anything I want, let's say x1. First square brackets will tell me or will depict the number of rows I want it to be, let's say of 4. And second square bracket will tell me the number of columns, that's again say 4. Okay. Now we'll start asking user to insert values in this matrix one by one. For that, we have to go through each and every row and column of this particular matrix. What I'm trying to say is, if I want user to input values dynamically, that is from its keyboard, then first I have to ask him enter the first row, first column entry, that is this one. Next, first row, second column, then first row, third column, and first row, fourth column. And as you know that the index of an array always starts with 0. Okay, so this particular element will have an index of 0, 0. Why? Because the first row will always be called as 0, and first column values, that is these values, will always be 0th column. Okay, so if I want let's say find out what is the index of this particular value, so the index of this would be, let's count first row, that is 0th row, first row, second row, third row. So the rowth index will be 3rd, and zeroth column, first column. And if I want 5 to be identified, then it's going to be 1. So the index of this particular element is 3, 1. Okay, and that is what we are going to do. We're going to ask the user to insert each and every value one by one. So we'll initialize two for loops. First for loop will count the number of rows, and second for loop will count the number of columns. So what we are going to do is, first I'm going to initialize a for loop which will count first row, and then inside that for loop I will initialize one more for loop, and that particular for loop will ask me the value of first row first column, first row second column, first row third column, first row fourth column entries. Okay, then the outer loop will iterate and increment by one, and we are now at row number second, and then again the initial for loop will start and it will ask us the value of second row first column, second row second column, second row third column, second row fourth column entry. Okay, so this is how we are going to iterate through each and every value of this particular 4x4 matrix, or whatever be the size of your matrix would be. So let's get back. So let's start with for loop. This for I equal to 0, I is less than 4, and I is plus. Okay, for j equal to 0, j less than 4, and j plus plus. Now as you see, we don't know what is I and what is j is, what is their type. So we'll also declare these two variables called int I comma j, that is it. Now the standard input function called scanf will be called for each and every value of the matrix one by one. So let's start with that, scanf, or let's insert a output function, print function first. Printf, and enter the value. Okay. Next, we are going to initialize a scanf function, or call a scanf function, and percentage d, because we are using integer, and ampersand is pointer of the location, and the name of the array is x1. Two square bracket will tell me which value I am interested in. Let's insert I and j. Now, let's go through this. For first, when we insert into this loop, the value of I is equal to 0. And I is less than 4, that is true. So we'll go inside that loop. That is the basic concept of for loop. We have already studied that. When we go inside that loop, another for loop will be initialized. And this for loop will first initialize the value of variable j equal to 0. Now this j is a value of 0, and it is certainly less than 4. So yes, we are going to be inside this loop. When we go inside that loop, first this particular command will be executed. That is, your console will see a string called enter the value. So now it's asking you to enter the value. Whatever you are going to insert or type through your keyboard will be assigned to this particular, let's say, memory location that has been assigned by the compiler when we have declared the error. So x1 I, the value of I in this first iteration is 0, and j in this first iteration is also 0. So actually the first location will be x1, 0 and 0. That is what we have defined, and I have told you the index of first element will be 0, 0. So that is what I have done here. And as we iterate through the loop, the values of I and j will start incrementing. So when we get out of this loop, the value of j will be 1. The 1 is definitely less than 4. Enter the value, scanf, x1, 0, 1, then again, x1, 0, 2, then again, x1, 0, 4. And this is how we'll go on. And when the value of j will increment it to 4, we'll come here, we'll see that value of 4 is not less than 4. And the conditional statement will fail and will get out of this particular loop. And after that, the value of I will be incremented for first time. We'll go here. Value of I is now 1. Now 1 is certainly less than 4. We'll go inside the loop again. This particular for loop will initialize. The value of j is initialized to 0. Again, 1 is less than 4. And this will happen again. But at this time, x1, the value of I will be 1 instead of 0. So we are now in the second row. That is, we have, the compiler has already asked you all these four values, and now it will start to ask you the value of second row, and then the value of third, and then the value of fourth. This is how the process will go on. Now let's try to print these values to see if it actually worked or not. Let's again initialized a for, let's say k is equal to 0 and k must be less than 4 and k plus plus. Why I'm using for loop again? To reach out to every value of a two-dimensional array, I have to go to each and every value. So if I want to print if I want to print this particular array, so I have to reach out to each and every value. Okay, so how we are going to do this, as we have seen just a few seconds before, we have to use two for loops. One for loop will let you know in which row you are in, and second for loop will let you know at which column you are in. Okay, same procedure. Again, for, let's say L is equal to 0, L is less than 4, and L plus plus. Now, we are inside this loop, but we haven't declared what are k and l. So I'll declare k as integer, l also as integer. So that is it. Now all we have to do is just write a printf statement, printf, and percentage d for integer, and tab. I want to print these values in this manner only, not like 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 2, 3, below that, and below that. We'll try to print the matrix in the form of matrix that you have seen in your mathematics books, actually. Okay. So, x1, sorry, but I, k, and l. Okay. K, and l, x1. Yeah, and it's also printf, and write an escape sequence for new line, so that whenever we finished up in printing first row, the next row should be printed in a new line. So this particular escape sequence called backslash n is used for new line, and this particular escape sequence called backslash t is used for tab. So let's try to debug it. first I have to save this file, and let's save it. As to the okay, what we have okay, we have not got the same color. Okay. Now it is short. Okay, enter the value. Let's start inserting those 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 13, 14, 15, 16. That is it. You can see we have entered all the values one by one, and it has printed it in the form of matrix, that is two-dimensional array. First row, number of rows are 4, number of columns are 4. So first row, second, third, and fourth. So I'll end this lecture right here, right now, and tomorrow we are going to start with functions. Thank you.